I can't blame Lisa, because if I was married to someone who like ran a Domino's, I would have cheesy bread every night.
Speaking of filler, do you think I need some more to kick off the new year?
I mean, Dr. Jen, are you listening? Are you listening? I mean, let's make it happen.
Virtual reality.
Hi, I'm Danny.
And I'm Evan. Welcome to 2022.
You know, it is a new year and there is some new drama, so get ready to spill some hot and fresh reality with us. Speaking of hot, Evan, we are down in Florida. I am loving Real Housewives of Miami on Peacock, and the drama, it's off the presses now. I mean, truly, they have taken a page, I guess, from every other housewife, and the cops are now involved because Alexia's son, literally as we are recording this, it was reported that he got arrested for domestic violence from his girlfriend.
I cannot believe it. I was rooting for Peter. I remember back in the day on the early seasons of Miami, his biggest problem was if he was gonna stick to his diet and become a male model. So this is super disappointing to hear about. It's super sad to see. I'm so sad that poor Alexia has been roped into even more family drama. She has already been through so much, and we just saw on this episode, she was trying to broker peace between Peter and her new husband. It didn't really work out so well, and now things are continuing not to work out for Peter, and I wish him the best.
It's so hard. Well, and I mean, it's one of those things, like her 2022 planner, it's literally like, meet my dead husband's gay lover, broker peace between like my family, bail my son out of jail, run a salon, and then like make time to have dinner with Larsa Pippen. Like, girl is booked and busy and not in the way anybody wants to be.
I cannot wait for the Alexia Echevarria biopic one day. I mean, Lifetime, come on.
It will be everything we need and more. But speaking of things that people no longer need, you chatted with Lisa, and she's starting this new year with a new face, kind of, maybe, or an old face, I guess I should say.
Yeah, I chatted with Lisa, who, as we know, is married to Dr. Lenny Hochstein, who is known as the boob god of Miami. So plastic surgery, cosmetic enhancements are just a big part of her life. And she actually opened a med spa with Lenny.
I did go overboard, you know, when we first opened our med spa, because everything was so accessible to me. I probably put too much of everything in my face, and I stopped doing all of that in the past 2 years. I've actually removed a lot of filler. It's like a work in progress.
And I know that she wants to go back to how she used to look. She wants to look like the real her again.
The her of like three faces in, not five faces in, you know what I mean? Because she's gorgeous, but I mean, let's be real. And I can't blame her, because if I was married to someone who like owned a Domino's pizza, do you not think I'd be having cheesy bread every night? Like, it's just part of it's occupational hazard.
I mean, yeah, like I can honestly relate, because I just moved to LA recently. I've had some Botox, I've gotten some filler in my lips. Believe it or not, I'm not naturally this gorgeous. After I got filler for the first time, it's all I could think about. I was like, oh my God, I need more, I need more, I need more. So I can totally relate to Lisa. But I'm going to look at this as a cautionary tale, and I'm not going to book my next appointment anytime soon. So
you're gonna hold off. You're gonna wait for that punch card to really get filled up. And I do think, honestly, why don't we just use nature's fillers? Like, butter really expends you. Not to put on you, just eat butter. You'll fill up. Trust me, Lisa. It is a tried and true New Jersey practice that I have done for decades now. So they are having a lot of drama, but of course we cannot forget about Salt Lake City. Mary, Mary, Mary. Mary had a little lamb, but a lot of drama going on over there. And I mean, she is being accused of being racist for what she said to Jenny.
You look amazing as a blonde, so does she.
Ah, you do have yellow tones. Well. I like the slanted eye.
We still have the cult thing going on. There's so much happening with her.
Look, Mary keeps it consistent. We remember it from season one, the weird 7-Eleven comment. So she decided to reprise this racist moment for herself on season two. And a few episodes ago, you'll remember that she compared Jen Shaw to a Mexican thug. Mm-hmm. I kind of think that the offense towards Jenny was a little bit worse, because she said it to her face multiple times.
It and was really went just in on so her. Long.
I am very proud of the way Jenny stood up for herself. She really shot back at Mary. And I'm also proud of Whitney Rose for standing up to Mary and basically calling her out, like, why do you think it's okay to say these things? Because I think other than Jenny and Whitney, the rest of the cast kind of breezed over it. And I truly think it's because people are terrified of Mary, and I get it. I'm terrified of Mary too. So it was very brave on Whitney's part to stand up for Jenny and say something. And you know what? Mary didn't really have an answer. She tried to say it was a compliment. We all know it wasn't a compliment. It was a microaggression, and
yeah,
she was scared to say it.
I know, I'm kind of, because I was disappointed, because Meredith usually likes to stand up, and whenever she's engaging, but I guess those feathers she was wearing was to fly away from the drama and not to like peacock herself out to be like, no, this is what's happening. So maybe she'll have a different outfit and a backbone next episode. You know who really is in the market for some loving right now? Lil Vicky and Lil Luann, because their men have all moved on and these girls are left alone and looking for love. How are we feeling about them being single, watching their exes go down the aisle again?
I'm just loving the reactions that they're giving. So Vicky told Page Six exclusively in response to Steve's engagement that he is a fame whore. So she has no well wishes for Steve. And it's so iconically Vicky, and I love it. She seems to be doing all right. And also, I chatted with Luann on the phone yesterday and I asked her to react to Tom's engagement.
That whole story is behind me, and it was, you know, gosh, more than 3 years ago, 4 years ago now. So I moved on, and you know, I only wish Tom the best.
So both women seem to be in a pretty okay place, or at least that's how they're trying to make it seem. I love that Andy has been so supportive, and he's really rooting for them both to find great guys in 2022.
You know, it's like, I feel like Andy opened up the DM hole where Vicky's like gonna DM and be like, what should I say to this person on this dating app? Like, should I just go back on the show? But I would watch a Housewives dating show. You know what I mean? Like, let these women mingle and mix and try it out like that. And I feel like Luann is really happy because she has never looked better. So she's, Tom, look in the mirror and then look at whoever Luann is going to be dating next and then realize, oh yeah, she's not going to the DI Casino grocery store anymore.
Yeah, she is single and very ready to mingle. She told me that she has a few months off at the beginning of the year from her cabaret tour. So she finally has the time to focus on dating. So fingers crossed it happens for Lou.
And I mean, she has her fauxé out, so she's gonna be ready to cheers the night away with any man who tickles her fancy. Well, also somebody who is really getting, making the most of a separation. Noella, I've never seen a housewife utilize social media in such a way where I'm like, you need to have like a YouTube channel in addition to this, because she really is giving no filter. And she's already like moving on with this new guy who's like, she says they're friends who like to kiss, so we are back in middle school, I guess, in that regard. But yeah, she seems to be moving on too, but also not moving out of the house that she's squatting in.
I feel like she is such a great addition to the show.
Yes.
She's coming in so hot and spicy. She's giving us everything we look for in a Real Housewife. She's messy. She's gorgeous. She has the one-liners. She's down to fight. Like, I'm loving everything about her.
Poor Jen Armstrong. Jen is sadly giving me, I love Jen, giving me some Teddy vibes when she's getting yelled at. She's like, what?
Wait, my Instagram? That is so weird to say that, Danny, because the entire last episode of Orange County, all I could think of was the parallels between Dr. Jen and Teddy. There's definitely a vibe that they share, for sure. And I just want to put it out there. I do love Jen. I'm not taking sides here. I really love both of them. I think they are both great additions. And when I make my next Botox appointment, I'm going to Jen. Well, speaking of that tagged photo, I feel like we didn't really get clarity. Was Noella really tagged or not? Because Dr. Jen didn't necessarily provide an answer. I think she said she didn't remember tagging her, but
yeah,
it would also be a very weird thing for Noella to make up. So I need to do some Instagram stalking and see if we can still find that photo and that tag.
That is true. I know we need to unpack that. Because that's what I was, when Heather went to ask a question, I was like, oh, we're going to get to the juice of it. And she was like, she had the question about lemonade. I was like, Heather, I'll explain that to you later, or ask one of your kids. We have to find out really what happened with this photo heard across Orange County.
Also, Noella saying that she works exclusively with another med spa. I need to know more about that. What do you mean you work exclusively with a med spa, Noella? I could watch like a 30-minute documentary on that.
Oh, I'm sure she'll post it to her Instagram tomorrow. So ask and ye shall receive. And that was a lot to unpack, and it is only the first week of January.
Tune in next week to see what kind of crazy drama continues to unfold in the new year.